hurry.
I have nothing to say to you.
That's okay. You don't have to talk. I can read your dinky little mind. Let me guess. You're on your way to Jason's house? And go throw yourself at him again? I have a little bit of advice that might save us all some time. Don't bother. You're pathetic.
I'm pathetic?
Yeah, you're pathetic, sweetie. Jason doesn't want you, Elizabeth. If he did, he wouldn't have got up and left your dinky little whatever you call that studio and made a beeline for his penthouse the minute he could walk.
You know what? I realize this is going to be difficult for you to wrap your selfish little mind around. But I'm actually glad that Jason's well enough to be on his own.
Oh, my God. How does he even stand, you little mealy-mouthed girls, anyway? Why don't you cut to the chase, okay?
Fine. What's your problem?
You are my problem. I want you gone. Go back to wherever it is you came from and leave Jason the hell alone. He does not want you. Do you understand? That's why he got up and left. So back off.
You walk straight back to you, Carly? I don't think so. That's your problem. You can't stand the fact that Jason trusts me, that he let me help him and sent you away. I realize you think you're this force of nature and everybody should just get out of your way and let you take whatever you want, but I'm not scared of you. And I'll see Jason whenever I want. So back the hell off.